I get to wear different hats every day. I get to visit different people, different facilities. Sometimes I'm in food processing facilities. Sometimes I'm in city buildings, public entities. Sometimes I'm in schools. It's a great feeling when you walk in a building after the project is done. Hey Tanuj, thanks for telling us about this. We love it. It worked. I'm Tanuj Gulati. I'm Senior Energy Engineer at Energy Management Solutions Incorporation. We have to first find out what customer is looking for. Usually we start by visiting people on the floor, talking to them and asking questions what they need to do to make this process or make this building more energy efficient. Once we have all that information, then we come back, we look at what's out in the market that can help this particular project or customer to attain what they are trying to do. Sometimes I start early depending on what the weather, if it will be too hot during the day, or sometimes I start late. We have worked in the past late hours because we wanted to see what's going on in the evenings when the facilities are off. We have visited facilities, I remember, at 2 in the morning just to see, are those night setbacks working? I did my bachelor's in mechanical engineering. I did my master's in mechanical engineering. I have attained certifications for Certified Energy Manager, Certified Energy Auditor, and Certified Lighting Efficiency Professional by Association of Energy Engineers. You have to be a strong communicator. You should be aware of these technologies that you are recommending. And then you should be a good presenter. You should be good in Excel so you can pull up these reports and show them, okay, this is what I'm saying, this is why I'm saying this. And these are your paybacks, these are your energy savings. I always carry with me a light meter to find out lighting levels and what can be done to still have those same lighting levels but with more efficient lighting. Sometimes we go do the audits, we would leave data loggers installed on the equipment so we can have a week's worth of data or 2 weeks worth of data so we can process that data and see if that what is that equipment doing when the plant is not running. Laptops are always handy for us to process reports right away. Sometimes we sit down in meetings where customer would like to know what do we think, so we process their data right away. We sit down and do some spreadsheets so we can have an idea of, okay, how the recommendations look like. We go and give presentations in schools, getting high school kids, getting high school students excited about energy conservation, and you would be surprised to know when principals or superintendents call you back and tell you what a great presentation you did. Children are leaving classrooms with their turning the lights off as they're leaving. We all know about greenhouse gases. Energy conservation has a direct impact on them. You use less energy, you need lesser power plants, lesser greenhouse gases. An example, if there are in a light fixture there are 4 lamps and I'm going in there and telling you to save energy by just using 2 lamps. Now you're recycling less lamps, less mercury. So there is a direct impact on environment with energy conservation. Until recently, it used to be a topic that was always on a second thought. It was an afterburner that, okay, is energy conservation really we should worry about? But since economy has changed, people are started worrying about profitability of their company. It's definitely becoming a separate entity, a separate field that all these big industries, big manufacturers, commercial buildings, cities are taking advantage of because they know they can do it. Try to visit websites like Association of Energy Engineers. Try to go and read what US Department of Energy has to offer. A lot of places, a lot of cities have these energy design conferences. Go visit them. Energy push by the federal government has helped our business a lot. There are a lot of grants out there that cities, public buildings are taking advantage of. There are a lot of grants that businesses are taking advantage of. Our customers are really happy with our services. They feel good. They feel that we are not taking away their savings. So that's what I like about my job.